Dave, I'm a huge fan of you and the guest. Oh, here I am on right there. I'm a 20-year-old in college. What are your ideas on majoring in exercise science or something that's related?
That's a college discussion.
Yeah.
Actually, let set the phone down. Let Jim and I have a talk on this one because he comes from a
very from prodigious a very, exercise science.
Well, no, but you come from a very high – your parents were both teachers.
Yes.
And we're running into a really weird time with college education as far as, say, you go into exercise science. By the time you pour all that money into that degree, you're never going to be able to get back out what you
put in. No, not even close.
So that – and now if you need a master's to be a strength coach, the odds of you ever being able to even pay back your student loans means you're going to be one of 10 people in the industry who are able to pull that much income.
I didn't even think about the –
So, yeah, I mean, unless there's a scholarship, if my advice is if you're bust your ass, get the best grade you can in high school, try to get the scholarships, whatever you can to be able
grants.
To knock the grants to knock it down. But if you got to pull a loan for the full thing, this isn't like when I went to school and I could work 2-3 jobs to pay for everything.
Yeah. You could pay in the summer.
Yeah. I mean, I walked away with zero student debt. Yep. So I can say, yes, my degree was worth it. It took me longer than everybody else, but it was definitely worth it. But I'm not sitting on $100,000 worth of debt looking at a job that may only pay me 27 grand.
Yeah. The only thing, if you can somehow get credits outside of a college, like a junior college, and then get them transferred.
There's an idea.
The only thing that I with the exercise science is – have you ever said it? You've said, yeah, what was your major?
Exercise science and nutrition.
Like, did they know anything, Dave?
No. I mean, nutrition, I took a lot of nutritional biochem, so yes, I did learn stuff there.
What I'm trying to say,
no.
Would you, if a kid just got whatever major and found ways of interning, got his foot in the door, right, of whatever major, got his foot in the door at a local college or something, and then ended up getting a GA there, now your master's is paid off. The internship is going to be worth more than the fucking degree.
If the internship is under somebody that teaches you how to do your own research. So you need to, now we're in a world where you have to vet information.
Yes, yes. Now, like 99% of what, 100% of everything that you and I have learned has not been in the classroom.
Correct.
100.
Correct. But now we got 90% of all the information on social media, YouTube, WordPress, everything
else. Oh, I see what
you're
saying. As far as whether the information is worthwhile.
It's being junk, but my kids don't know how to disseminate between what they're finding on YouTube or what they're finding elsewhere.
That's why you intern.
They have to have somebody that knows how to teach them. It's more than just learning how to Google.
Yes. Yeah. But that's where the intern comes in, and that's where your own training comes in.
Yes.
And even when I was coaching at Kentucky, I was training people outside of it. So it was like this constant process of, and it wasn't because I wanted to learn. It was because this is what I love to do. That makes sense to you? Like, oh, if I can train you, I don't give a shit. You know, you pay me whatever. It doesn't have to be much. But I don't know if the exercise science degree, like you said, is going to be worth it in the end because of all the money. I think nothing is going to replace in any field hands-on and networking.
That's true. Because with the staff that we hire, I'm not going to say we don't look at the resumes, but it's what we look at last.
I have never in my life given a resume.
Yeah, I've only...
Hey, do you even know if I graduated college? All you have is my fucking word. Yeah. Yeah. Did it matter?
Well, at the time, no.
No.
No. Because and that was
I
knew you could fill the role that we were looking for better than anybody else that was out there. And but with the people that we bring in now, you know, it's pretty easy saying we had to, you know, replace a customer service. Rhonda's been here forever.
Yes.
So she's still here. I love her to death, but she needs an assistant, so we had to bring in another assistant for her. And you know, within 5 minutes of speaking to this person, this is gonna work or not.
Yep.
Just from a personality standpoint, I don't know where she went to school. I don't even know if she graduated high school. I don't fucking care. I care about how she treats that customer on the other end of the line. You know, and, you know.
Jay Ellis saying that as well about his hiring.
I mean, I kind of know Josh's degree because we really had to have somebody that knows film.
Yeah.
So I was like, fuck, we better find nobody. How, I don't know. Here's where it matters. When the person hiring doesn't have a fucking clue.
Well, that's the, I was watching something on YouTube the other day about top 10 things millionaires do or something. And they do a really good job of animating while they talk.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's like a fun video. And my son kind of likes it. And it's like, the value is I'm like, okay, wake up early, get your shit done. And then I watched something that that company did on the only three exercises you need. I was like, they're fucking horrible. Mm-hmm. I'm like, wait a minute. Everything else saying, because I don't know what the top 10 things for millionaires are.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess I kind of do, but you know what I'm saying. And I was like, eh, maybe you're fucking lying about everything else. Like, I don't know enough about film to know, like, hey, you're full of shit, dude.
Yeah.
Because there's always going to be a 5-through-1 dude who can understand, explain things fairly easy and gets everything. Does that make sense?
Yes. Network. Yeah. Just exactly what you said.
And, but I don't know. I don't know enough. Like, maybe he's the guy. Maybe you just fucking hired John Davies.
Yes.
Do you know what I'm saying? Yeah. And that's where it starts getting hairy. And then,
See, I like the millionaire stuff because it's like, dude, go ahead, go to bed at 8:30 at night, go to bed at 9 o'clock at night. Cause I'm going to start working at 11. Because all the real evil shit comes out after midnight.
Yeah.
All the kids go home when the lights go on.
Yeah.
I start working when the lights go off. So when you wake up early in the morning, my shit's already done. So you're not getting the jump on me, motherfucker.
Well, that was someone asked me one time is like, what time do you wake up? I'm like, I wake up when my eyes open.
That's
like,
when I get up.
I don't have this, and now for years I would wake up, especially when I was a kid, all through junior high and high school, I was always up early. Then when I went to the Air Force Academy, I was up early, and then I was like, you know what's awesome, Dave? He's fucking sleeping. Yeah. And I'll never forget John Meadows, his first day that after he quit his job, his first day he woke up without an alarm. He's like, dude, I felt so good.
Mm-hmm.
And so I just wake up when I wake up, which is not very late. But the good thing is if I can't sleep that night, I can sleep.
Well, here's the thing, you're creative. Your work is creative. So you could be laying there watching Netflix at 9 and be like, oh, fuck.
Yeah.
And now you're on a roll until 2:30 in the morning, but what, fuck, you're supposed to go to bed at 9 to get up at 6?
So I get some shit done at 4:30?
Yeah.
Drinking coffee?